On the Tibetan Plateau, something extraordinary is happening. A dam is rising, 180 meters tall and stretching across one of the most remote landscapes on Earth. But what makes this structure truly remarkable isn't its size. It's how it's being built. No workers with hard hats. No crews pouring concrete or operating cranes. This dam is being constructed entirely by machines. Bulldozers, trucks, rollers, and excavators, guided by a central artificial intelligence system, are building the world's largest 3D-printed structure. It's a fully autonomous construction site. Human engineers oversee the process remotely, but not a single worker sets foot on site. The machines operate around the clock, precisely executing a digital blueprint, one layer at a time. Welcome to the future of construction. At the heart of this operation is a system that functions more like an orchestra than a job site. A central AI slices a massive digital blueprint into thousands of layers. Each machine, whether it's transporting material, compacting it, or measuring progress, knows its role in each layer. Bulldozers shape the terrain. Trucks deliver fill material. Rollers compact it to exact tolerances. All of it is done autonomously, with vehicles moving in synchronized flows like an automated ballet. This AI doesn't just give orders. It receives constant feedback from sensors embedded in the machines. That feedback fine-tunes every movement in real time, ensuring precision and preventing costly errors. The result? A structure that's being built faster and potentially more accurately than anything human crews could manage. If you wanted to test the limits of autonomous construction, the Tibetan Plateau might seem like a brutal choice. It's one of the harshest environments on Earth. The air is thin, the weather extreme, and the ground unstable due to melting permafrost and seismic activity. But it's also one of China's most strategically important regions. The plateau is home to the headwaters of major rivers like the Yellow River, which support hundreds of millions of people downstream. China's long-term goals include increasing hydropower output, improving water security, and stabilizing the energy grid with renewable sources. Building on the Tibetan Plateau isn't just about generating electricity, it's about controlling the taps of some of Asia's most vital water supplies. This isn't the first dam at this location. The original Yangqu Dam was completed in 2010 using traditional construction methods. By 2016, it was producing 1,200 megawatts of power, enough to power a city the size of San Diego. But China's appetite for clean energy has only grown. As part of its pledge to reach carbon neutrality by 2060, the country is investing heavily in smarter, cleaner infrastructure. Instead of simply scaling up the old model, engineers took a bold leap. What if a new version of Yangqu could be built not by people, but entirely by machines? Labor shortages are a growing issue across China. The country's working age population is shrinking, and younger generations are less interested in labor-intensive industries. At the same time, demand for large-scale infrastructure is increasing. Automation offers a way out of this dilemma. Machines don't get tired. They don't need breaks. They can work with precision day and night, and they can operate safely in environments that are dangerous for humans. The central AI overseeing the Yangqu site doesn't just speed things up. It dramatically reduces the chance of errors. Every action is measured, tracked, and verified. The result is not just efficiency, but consistency. This dam isn't being printed with a giant robotic arm. Instead, the entire construction site functions as one massive 3D printer. Here's how it works. Trucks load up on building material and transport it to the site. Bulldozers spread it into place. Rollers then compact the material to precise density levels. Sensors measure the results, and that data goes back to the AI, which adjusts instructions for the next layer. This cycle, load, transport, place, compact, measure, report, is repeated over and over. The dam rises not by pouring concrete, but by layering and compacting earth in precise steps. One of the key advantages of this system is its ability to self-correct. Each roller is equipped with high-resolution sensors that monitor how well the material is compacted. If something is off, the data is flagged immediately. The AI processes this feedback and modifies its instructions in real time. No need to halt work, wait for an inspection, or redo layers later. It's a self-improving loop that ensures each stage is verified before the next one begins. Think of it like a 3D printer that checks every layer before printing the next. Only on a scale of millions of tons of earth and hundreds of meters of elevation. For all the technological marvels, this project isn't without controversy. The Tibetan Plateau is a delicate ecosystem. It contains glaciers and permafrost that are crucial to regulating Asia's climate and water cycles. Building massive dams here risks accelerating permafrost melt, disrupting natural river flows, and threatening local wildlife. Some experts worry that altering this region could have ripple effects that reach far beyond China's borders. Then there's the human cost. Local communities are often relocated for large infrastructure projects, and the construction may disturb culturally significant sites. The introduction of heavy equipment and non-native materials also brings long-term risks to biodiversity. There's another dimension to this story, jobs. While automation brings efficiency, it also replaces thousands of construction workers. In a country facing a demographic crunch, this might seem like a practical step, but it raises deeper questions. Who benefits from this efficiency, and who is left behind? Automation often concentrates wealth and decision-making power in the hands of those who control the technology. China sees automation as a way to future-proof its infrastructure plans. But the rest of the world will need to consider how to balance progress with equity. Yangqu Dam might just be the beginning. China has already experimented with 3D-printed buildings, folding bridges, and kinetic walkways that adapt to pedestrian flow. The long-term vision is clear. Entire smart cities built with minimal human labor, roads, buildings, bridges, all constructed faster, safer, and more precisely using fleets of autonomous machines. If it works, this could transform not just how we build, but who gets to build, and at what cost. So what is Yangqu Dam, really? A glimpse into the future of construction? Or a high-stakes experiment in one of the world's most sensitive regions? It promises speed, precision, and progress, but it also forces us to confront difficult questions about labor, ethics, and the environment. What do you think? Is this the future we should embrace, or a path we should tread carefully? Let us know in the comments below. If you found this story thought-provoking, share it. And if you want to see more deep dives like this, make sure you're subscribed.